I want to do it again.
This year we brought 6 cars, and I think there was 22 people on our team ever. Yeah, I think as a matter of fact, it was the biggest team ever entered into a race, car race event, anytime, anywhere, ever. This one here, Ron Bartley and Duncan are getting what they deserve.
Thanks for coming to the show.
When Ron was trying out his car
at
my shop before we got here, he was so excited to show us the car. He said, "Let me show you how the engine sounds." So he gets into the car, which is parked behind my car, turns it on and pops the clutch and rams it into the back of my car. Hence the name, Ramrod Ron.
Do you have any video evidence?
We're developing it.
In racing, things happen, and it could be the smallest thing or a big thing. So I never concern myself with who may have a better car than me or who may have more skill than me. In this particular event, it's a race of attrition. When I started Targa, it's been a whole year. You've forgotten a lot. I'm nervous. Would lie if I said I wasn't. I'm nervous. Nowhere near as nervous the first time I ever did it, but nervous nonetheless. And excited.
Let's do this.
...1800 crescent, right four, long downhill.
You know, we're shaking out some rough spots, but I think we're doing well. I don't think we've had any trouble today. Okay. And the idea is to get smoother as the week goes on.
It's a father-son event. Yes. And no.
Well, I sort of leave him on his own in his division, and I take care of myself and my people in my division. So we run as two separate entities.
Our wheels tonight. We actually took this car out after Thoroughgoods drove it in, and basically it stalled on the road, left me stranded. We had to get all the guys to push it back in, and we found parts that were loose.
Today Ruth and Andrew were a little bit hard on the car, and they hit one bump a little too hard and bent the rim, put the wheels out of alignment, and knocked the fuses. They knocked the fuses out of the fuse box, so tonight when we went to test it, it wouldn't start. So hopefully they drive the car a little more sanely tomorrow. They don't have to push it so hard.
on day two, and basically we're on a remote leg. The car had an impact against a cement wall, and it's broken some parts.
And we had to deal, I had to deal with tow trucks in the middle of the night to pick up wrecked cars and wrecked people emotionally. It was very challenging, and stay focused on my driving. Driving is, you know, surprisingly good. I mean, listen, he's been all but once. He's finished every year. He's consistently up at the top. Always worried that he's going to wreck out. See, he drives very aggressively, but he's also an extremely good driver.
700, double caution, left four over crest. 100, crest in the left three. 1300 left three.
He's a really, really good driver. Safety car went through too fast or lost control. He's the car that goes before we go. So the guy that's checking to make sure the course is clear drove off the course. So that has held us up an extra half hour while they cleared his car off the course.
Setting a good example. Safety, yeah. Crashing. Hope everyone's okay.
Here's one not to do.
Hopefully now that he's back and we've waited an extra half hour, we haven't lost our edge. We'll find out in a minute. Pretty tough. It gets to the grind and you say, that's it, I'm not coming back. But we do anyway. I really enjoy training newbies how to do the race, how to navigate, and how to drive. And I just like being there. I like the event. I like the time off. And I like the distraction from my job.
Lunches for our other members.
We didn't, yeah, we never even went that far. We just turned.
Ooh. Got a happy wife, happy life, you know? Yeah.
I got some white chocolate for me. And two little ones for the missus.
And right now what we're just trying to do is look at getting them through the week, and we're going to monitor them day by day, because if it comes a point where it's not safe to drive, we'll have to tell them.
But today's the day. Today's a technical day. All the speed is gone now for the rest of the week. It's all technical. They're all tight town stages. They're fun, but they're going to be very challenging to
get your time some. So looking forward to it. It's certainly going to be a day that people collect points.
Small crest and the right three.
So I just come up behind him.
How was that, John? Did you do that again?
Didn't even.
No, he didn't know you were there. Oh.
Yeah, it'd still go, with or without him. Wouldn't be the same though.
Now the one thing I can say is that my closest competitor on the first run in Brigus, he happened to go off right where I have a special instruction in my book, because I usually do something dumb right where he did. So I won't tell you what my instruction was, because this family show.
180 acute left. 100 acute left, don't fuck up.
Got it.
Don't fuck up.
Got it.
And I like to think that I really drive on the edge of that fine line between, you know, finishing and not finishing with respect to saving the equipment. I feel I know where the balance is. And again, some things are out of my control, but so far, knock on wood, I've been fine.
The last race, Friday, we were like 2 seconds apart till the last race. Which is the way it should be.
33, you have put 30.
I was exhilarated because I knew I couldn't have driven it any better. the weather was perfect. It was dry. It was warm. I had a lot of fun. I didn't make any mistakes in Brigus this year. So for me, when I finished the line, I was ecstatic that it was over. I was sad that it was over. You get a whole multitude of emotions.
Feeling really good. I had accomplished my three wins, which is something I've always aspired to do.
So to finish in the number one spot with my dad, that was pretty cool.
I stop it.
What a great week we had, aside from the fact that we lost the Mini to a crash, the old Mini, and Ron's car to a crash. But it looks like we're all on the podium, the rest of us, hopefully. Me first, Craig second, my son first in his vision, and John Riddell's third, I think. We think.
Let me know if you want
it has to be confirmed, but we think that's it. So I'm pretty excited about that. All four cars left are on the podium.
In Grand Touring, longtime competitors, longtime successful competitors in the Mini GP, John Hume Sr. and Christina Kroner.
Thank you very much. We've been doing this race for 9 years, my team, and it seems to grow like cancer every year. This year we managed to scrape together six cars. Something happened on day two. We lost two. These things happen. That's why we brought so many cars.
I've been doing this event since 2009, and finally, victory! Yes! I want to thank all the volunteers, because again, without them, none of this would happen. Everybody on this stage, thank you very much. Okay? Hope. And my crew, God bless them. Let's not forget them. If they weren't here, I wouldn't be here. So thank you very much, Centennial College. You guys rock.
Yes, we're both registered to go.
Well, I tried to be that, you know, stereotypical BMW driver and take as many spots as I could.
So I think I scooped up one, two, three, four, six.
I think that's pretty good.